you remember this guy, right? He's our very own Florida man, Matt Heller of Tampa. And he went viral on his purple kayak as the water rose in his home when Hurricane Helene hit. Thankfully, he is safe and his house got pretty nasty afterwards, but Matt found some way to stay cheerful and frankly optimistic through all of it. Well, now, unfortunately, Matt is getting ready to deal with another hurricane, this time Hurricane Milton, and has again decided to ride out the storm from his Tampa Bay home. Matt is back with me tonight. Matt, I have to tell you, so many people are specifically concerned and worried about you. So I'm glad to see you and glad to see that you continue to do well. But the storm is coming. And the Tampa mayor is saying that you really should evacuate. Why are you risking by staying?
Thank you, Ms. Coates. We have to stop meeting this way.
Me too.
I've been watching the weather really close. Like I said, I've been, going through this for 42 years as a native Floridian, and I take it real seriously. I've just been watching the weather as it shifts. It's, it's such a slow-moving system. Better safe than sorry, but this is where I plan to be. I have a life jacket. I got some lights, more battery packs. I'm a lot more prepared, and I'm hoping for the best. So we're just kind of hunkering down in place for the time being.
Who's the we? I mean, is your girlfriend going to ride it out with you again? And I wonder what your family thinks about you staying.
My mom was definitely a little alarmed. She was suggesting maybe I wear some sort of helmet as well to protect myself. I'm hoping that the home doesn't collapse or anything, blow away or anything like that. My girlfriend is here. She spent the day with her family, but then we were missing each other. So I went and picked her up and I told her if it gets too sticky tomorrow, I'm going to send her home and we'll kind of go in as it is. We don't even have rain here in Tampa yet. So I'm thinking we have at least another 20, 21 hours to try to watch this thing and see how it develops. I feel terrible for the folks in Sarasota, but mm-hmm. at the same time, I feel, we may have dodged a bullet here in Tampa. It's just too early to tell with these things.
I mean, you're right to think about any wobble of that trajectory might impact which area gets hit the hardest, but the entire state really has been on alert. And you told me last time the kayak was your escape plan. You have it again? Is it ready?
I have the kayak, I have a life jacket, and I even inflated I have an inflatable unicorn that I aired up yesterday. So
what?
I have a couple more escape options. It's safety first, I'm trying to make my mom happy here. So if anything, I could do rescue on the unicorn, maybe save some stranded neighbors. We'll see. But again, I'm hoping it doesn't flood like it did last time. And we're just taking it minute by minute, day by day, and just watching the weather.
My goodness, I'm thinking about somebody thinking they need a superhero rather than the bat in Gotham City being projected. It's some unicorn and you are coming instead. And I hope everyone's safe. But your neighborhood, it still has tons of debris left over from Helene. I mean, a lot of it. And frankly, Milton could bring wind speeds near, we're hearing 130 miles per hour. That debris could become projectiles. Aren't you concerned about that?
Absolutely. It's been 11 days. We followed all the instructions from the city, which was, leave our construction debris unbagged out on the curb. It felt like littering to me. I never would have thought it would kind of still be out there 11 days later. I know it's a huge monumental task, but I was kind of surprised they didn't have some more support and, get some more boots on the ground to help with the cleanup, especially for areas like mine that are so close to these waterways. And I just worry about those construction debris clogging any kind of drainage systems or impeding any other type of rescue attempts of anyone that needs it. I don't know. It is what it is. There's no playbook for this. Two historic storms so close back to back like this. I applaud everyone that has been putting in the long hours, and it's just a tricky situation.
There are so many people who are desperately trying to make sure everyone can stay safe. What are your cars? What are you going to do with your cars? What about your business?
Yeah, I worked. Today was a normal work day. We have paid time off tomorrow, so we will be closed. I was hoping that the roof and everything maintains and holds strong. We're moving some product around in our warehouse at Horn Blasters. I'm just kind of hoping for the best. I don't really have insurance there either, and it is time for a new roof. But again, we'll see. As long as there's no loss of life, that's the main thing. Yeah, any of the other stuff will be fine.
Matt Heller, I got to tell you, you are a walking emoji. Smiling and optimistic. Thank you so much. We hope you sincerely stay safe. We'll see you tomorrow night. Please stay safe, okay?
Thank you, Laura. Thank you.